It's like I'll say to the same religious leaders who keep coming out and telling you to pray. The people who rule the world right now are not praying. They're committing ritualistic sacrifices and they are destroying the moral fiber and fabric of human society while you are telling us to just pray and it will be all right. You are not going to overcome this way. The only way that we will be able to overcome is if we create better systems for ourselves, by ourselves, within our own definition, for our own vision of the future. We used to create civilizations. We used to create human civilizations. We used to create the best technologies in the world. Now what do we create? Bank accounts and Instagram accounts, which are owned by Europeans. So don't tell me about, you know, we just need to be peaceful and pray and overcome, because you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And you've never known what the fuck you're talking about. You haven't read enough books to even be able to have a conversation about what society is supposed to look like. So how are you supposed to tell me what I'm supposed to do? So do not listen to these people, because these people are idiots and they are here to distract you. And that's what celebrities originally were. They were just distraction. What we need to be focused on is doing for ourselves. We need to be focused on owning our own systems. We need to be focused on making Africa stronger. And you might say, yeah, well, you know, it's all right for you because you are where you are. I am where I am because I would rather be here than over there. And within a breath, I will be in Africa making things work as I'm supposed to be, because I was never supposed to be in the West and I was never supposed to be colonized. I was never supposed to even be speaking English. So what happened with the world is that some people decided that they would rule and control the world, and look at the world. They've had long enough to rule and control the world and they have destroyed the world. I'm sick and tired of people parading Zuckerberg and Gates and Bezos in my face, the stories of success. These people have stolen, they have looted the world, and you're telling me that I'm supposed to want to try and be like them? No, thank you. So whether it's these people telling you to come out for peace, or them taking a picture of themselves and telling you to buy some shit that you don't need, or whether it is the government lying to you again, as they've historically been lying to you and telling you that the only solution is to mandatory vaccinate you, or whether it is the media portraying this narrative and this rhetoric of Africans as the destroyers and the bastards of the planet, when they are the bastards of the planet and they have destroyed the planet, don't listen to them. You need to start taking your own future into your own hands. You need to start reading. You need to start practicing self-love with your brothers and sisters and start to learn about who you are and where you are and what you want for this planet. And don't listen to any of that nonsense that they tell you to do, because if Europeans are coming out and rioting when they were not concerned about the racial dichotomy for the last 200 years, they're coming out and rioting when life is fine, then you need to be worried about what is really going on. Why is it that the police are trying to start a riot? You don't want to be joining in with a riot that police are trying to start. There has to be a bigger plan at play. What is the bigger plan at play? Well, it is surveillance capitalism. It is authoritarian capitalism. It is being able to rule and control you indefinitely. It is making it so that your entire life not only goes from being a policed policy officer, police state, but you also being surveilled by the big tech companies that are trying to get you to spend as much time on your device as possible, so that they can using their surveillance capitalism, sell you shit that you don't need so that they can become richer while you are scared in your house. The dollar used to be, well, it first started out, the first stocks that were traded were slaves, and then the dollar was backed by gold. And then France said to the USA, we want to take our gold out of the USA because of Vietnam, because they couldn't afford to print as much money as that they were printing out, and it wasn't backed by anything. And then they created a war on drugs. And after the war on drugs, they created a war for oil. And then after the war for oil, they created a war for debt. So they tried to get as many people in debt as possible, and the mass incarceration happened around this time as well, in between the war on drugs and the war on oil. That led up to the war on debt, and now they have a war for data. You ask the big tech companies what they want from you. They want data. That's what they want. And the ones who have the most data are the ones that are king. So that's why you need to have as much data as possible, because these people now are trying to create a system where they can completely control you, where you are just in your home. You're minding your own business and you're getting adverts for shit that you're talking about. They have microphones in your house. They have cameras. Right now I'm talking to a camera. You think that this camera isn't being watched? They are all being watched. You are being monitored every single way you go. And what you need to start worrying about is not who is the best team or who is the best religion or who to vote for. You need to start worrying about what you are going to do if the state turns hostile against you. If you can get a legal firearm, get a legal firearm. If you can do some tactical training, do some tactical training, because a lot of the people in the country where you are tactically trained and you're not. So just think about that for a second. And ultimately, it is about you owning your own end-to-end supply chain, economically, militarily, the police, the energy system, the water system. Anything that you use, you need to have owned by you, and you need to not be owned by these people who continue to try and take away your rights and freedoms so that they can give you safety. What is safety? Them completely controlling you. And that's all it is. It doesn't matter whether you are black, it doesn't matter whether you are brown or yellow or white. People who have power are trying to control you. They've been trying to control you since the beginning of time. It's just black people, we get the worst of it. And then we get all these people coming out and telling us to do exactly what the same media that we don't trust half the rest of the time, and the politicians that we don't know half of the rest of the time until they want our vote, are telling us to do. And all they're telling us to do is lie down and take it. And now is the time to stop taking it. Now is the time to start to rise up, and don't get angry and just go and protest. You need to educate yourself. You need to read books. A great start is a book called Blueprint for Black Power by Amos Wilson. Read these books, please, because these celebrities do not know what they are talking about. And they're entertainers. Their purpose is to enter you into a containment field to liberate you or to keep you distracted. So if they are not liberating you, then they are keeping you distracted.